one suitable setup to allow us to study this harmonic motion is to attach a ball here to the rim of a turntable of radius A and to use a source of light like this lamp here. And here you have a screen. And now if you follow the length of the shadow as the turntable rotates, this length will move a simple harmonic motion, very much similar to the motion of this mass here, back and forth, okay? So the same applies to the shadow here. And the velocity, as we found before, would be a constant multiplied by square root of a squared minus x squared. So now, if we analyze the motion here of this vector A that represents the shadow on the screen, this is the distance. Remember the radius of the turntable is A, and this is the instantaneous value of the displacement. This is the amplitude A when it was at this point, okay? And X is oscillating back and forth between minus A and plus A, between minus A and plus A. So it's much similar to the spring, but now we can understand it better. So at any point like this point, the velocity vector is tangent to the circular trajectory, and the horizontal component of the velocity can be calculated from this velocity with cosine this angle or sine the complementary angle. So here V equals V naught sine theta. V equals V naught sine theta from this triangle. Sine theta equals V divided by V naught. Remember from trigonometry, the sine function is equal to the opposite divided by the hypotenuse. For this angle, this is the opposite and this hypotenuse. So it is V divided by V naught. And V is square root of A squared minus X squared, and V naught is A. Okay, so now we have this nice relationship between the instantaneous velocity and the maximum velocity. Okay, we may write it this way. So now we know how to model the velocity. Before that, we were talking about X and then how the potential energy is converted into kinetic energy, how half Ka squared is equal to half mv maximum squared. The maximum is V naught. And this is just a setup that allow us to model the experiment. Here we have also a simple harmonic motion in the drive wheel of a locomotive. The rods connected to a piston that moves back and forth in simple harmonic motion, and the rods transform the back and forth motion of the piston into rotational motion, which is a harmonic or periodic motion that repeats over and over again. Now, back to the turntable experiment. The period can be calculated. It is the circumference, which is 2 pi a. A is the radius, remember, a is the radius, 2 pi a, divided by the velocity. So when you divide the distance, which is the circumference, by the velocity, you get the period of oscillation, right? Always dividing distance by velocity, you get time, you get period, okay? So from this equation, we have this result for the velocity. When you solve for the velocity, V naught is 2 pi a divided by t, okay? And as we learned earlier, the total potential energy, half k a squared, is equal to the total kinetic energy of mv naught squared. This is maximum kinetic energy. This is maximum potential energy. Energy is conserved. So maximum potential is the same as maximum kinetic. So from this formula, we have for A over V naught, square root of M over K. So now we substitute for A over V naught here, for A over V naught, substitute square root of M over K. Therefore, the period is 2 pi multiplied by square root of M over K. This is a nice equation that allow us to calculate the period of oscillation for an object on a rotating table or for an object oscillating back and forth, okay, on a horizontal surface. It's the same motion. We are just modeling the same motion by different ways, okay? So the period here is 2 pi multiplied by square root of m divided by k. This is a nice and important result that we obtain. We needed to solve problems. So we see that the greater the mass for the mass attached to the spring, the greater the mass, the greater would be the period. Okay, we have this mathematical dependence. Now for the frequency, we know that frequency is 1 over t, reciprocal of the period. Therefore, frequency is 1 over 2 pi square root of k over m. We know that frequency can be expressed in cycles per seconds, which we call it hertz, or in radians per second. We know that each cycle contains 2 pi radians. 2 pi radians. So you can convert from frequency in cycle per second into frequency in radian per second, simply multiply f by 2 pi. So this is omega, 2 pi f. Okay, so 2 pi cancels with 2 pi, and we have this nice result, omega equals square root of k over m. Remember, k is the spring constant, and m is the mass attached to the spring. Check your understanding. An object of mass m is attached to a horizontal spring, stretched to a displacement a from equilibrium, and released. So that's the amplitude. Undergoing harmonic oscillations on a frictionless surface with period t naught. The experiment is then repeated with a mass of 4m. Choose the new period of oscillation. Okay? Choose the new period of oscillation. This is the equation that you will need. T equals 2 pi square root of m over k. So in this question, we changed m into 4m. Okay? So the answer for this one will be 2 t naught, okay? When you substitute for m, 4m, square root 4 is 2, okay? So it would be twice the original period. An object of mass m is attached to a horizontal spring stretched to a displacement a from equilibrium and released undergoing harmonic oscillations on a frictionless surface. The experiment is then repeated with a mass of 4m compared to the original total mechanical energy, the subsequent to total mechanical energy of the object with mass 4m is. Any suggestion?
I think it will be greater, yeah. Equal?
The total energy, remember, the total energy is half kA squared.
Oh, so it doesn't involve the mass.
Half kA squared. So
yeah.
There is no dependence on mass.
And then,
depends on A. Since A is the same, then the energy is the same.
Right? Same. Okay.
Yeah. Thank you.